Hey 10th graders, hope you're all doing well and staying safe. Welcome to this real quick video in which I'm going to give the instructions for your biology work. So in biology, we're actually talking about DNA. In our previous chapters, we talked about genetics, we talked about heredity, we talked about what DNA or genes do, but we haven't really talked about the structure of DNA. So that's actually what we're going to be seeing in these next pages. So what we're going to be talking about is what kind of structure DNA has. We know that DNA kind of looks like a spiral ladder, right? And on the pages of your book, you're going to find more details as to why the structure is that way. You're going to talk a little bit about the history of when it was discovered and what nitrogen bases form DNA and so on and so forth. So once you've seen this video, you guys are going to go to page 216 of your textbooks. You're going to read pages 216 through 219, and then you're going to answer the formative assessment on page 219, questions 1 through 3, guys. If you do have any questions regarding your biology work, you can feel free to text me or email me. I am always at the disposition to talk to you guys. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, that in going a little bit in depth into what the DNA structure is, the DNA structure was actually discovered in about 1953, the actual structure of the DNA. So we're talking a little bit over 60 years, 66, 67 years ago. And in that short amount of time, a lot has been understood about genetic disorders like we saw in previous chapter, or heredity like we saw in chapter 6. But also, DNA structures have been influential in understanding proteins, and we know that proteins determine a function, and the function actually determines what it's used for. For example, the amino acid that makes the protein for skin color is used, or is what gives us our pigmentation, which helps protect us, our skin, from UV rays. Now, if this sounds interesting to you, and I'm pretty sure it does because it is, you're going to once again go to page 216 of your textbook and read pages 216 through 219, and you're going to answer formative assessment 1 through 3. So if you have any questions, let me know. Stay safe, guys, and I'll see you soon. Bye.